Dear cadets in class 7 of Borishal Cadet College, Assalamualaikum. How are you all? I hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Now, I am going to introduce myself with you, cadets. I, Muhammad Idi Amin, your teacher, demonstrator in the Department of Biology at Borishal Cadet College. Today, I will take your science class. I welcome to my class. Cadets, you know, this is the time of corona pandemic. Protect yourself from COVID-19. For this reason, you must be follow some instructions. At first, wash your hand frequently with soap and water. Avoid going to any crowded place. Avoid unnecessary touching in your eyes, nose, and mouth. Don't go out, but if you want to go for any emergency reason, you must wear a mask and hand gloves. Don't go out infected person, cadets. Finally, you must maintain a safe distance from anyone who is coughing or sneezing. Okay, boys, let's start our class. Today's subject is science. Our topic, Entamoeba and cellular organisms. Dear boys, after studying this lesson, you will be able to know, explain the risk and way out from human health hazards created by virus, bacteria, and entamoeba. Then explain how to be self-conscious and also make other conscious to resist these health hazards. Then draw leveled drawings of plants and animal cells. Compare plant and animal cell and explain structure and function of different organelles of cells. Okay, let's start our topic. Our topic is entamoeba. Cadets, we know entamoeba is a genus of amoebozoa found as internal parasites of animals. It is a unicellular organism which belongs to the kingdom Protista. In 1875, Russian scientist Fodor Loss described the first proven case of amoeboid dysentery. Boys, now I am going to describe structure and disease of entamoeba. Cadets, we know its body has no definite shape because they continuously change size and shape. In entamoeba, first two types of dysentery, such as amoeboid and bacillus. When the patient bears the germs without any symptoms, it is very difficult to cure amoeboid dysentery completely. That is, I am sure the disease of entamoeba completely cured when a patient, you must a competent doctor is is consulted and taken proper medicine. Next, we discuss about the role of microwaves in creating health hazards. Thus, we can see many organisms around us. Besides this organism, there are numerous invisible organisms which cannot be seen by bare eyes. At first, bacteria, cholera, typhoid, etc. are bacterial diseases. Bacterial spores may travel from one place to another with the dust in the air. It may easily get transferred through shaking hands. Germs disperse easily through stool and rotten food. Then virus. Boys, we know AIDS, mumps, pox, etc. are very painful viral diseases. These viral diseases are transmitted through air and get into the respiratory tracts. Carriers. Next, I am going to describe on the prevention and remedy of health hazards caused by microbes. Boys, we know prevention is better than cure. For prevention of the disease caused by virus, bacteria, fungi, and entamoeba, a joint effort is needed to follow the rules of hygiene carefully. At first, wash your hands often. Be smart about food preparation. Use antibodies sensibly. Get vaccinated. Stay at home if you have signs and symptoms of an infection. Then avoid the hot zones in your residence. Don't share personal items. Finally, you don't shaking hands. Next, we discuss remedy of health hazards caused by microbes. When attacked, the patient should call in a doctor and take his advice. Boys, you know, used if needed, proper medicine should be taken. Boys, you must be follow used antibodies only for infected caused by bacteria. Carrots, next we discuss cellular organization of plants and animals. Boys, do you know what is cell? The cell is the basic structural, functional, and biological unit of all known organisms. A cell is the smallest unit of life. Cells are often called the building blocks of life. Boys, we know in 1665, the scientist Robert Hooke found this for the first time. Boys, you can see the diagram of a plant cell. Carrots, look at the picture. This is a typical plant cell. This is a typical transcend. Its structure is chloroplast, cell wall, cell membrane, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and other rough endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, nucleolus, a large vacuole, cytoplasm, Golgi body, lysosome, and mitochondria is present. Boys, now we discuss a structure of a typical plant cell. A typical plant cell comprises of two parts, cell wall and protoplasm. At first, cell wall. A plant cell wall was first observed and named simply as a wall by Robert Hooke in 1665. Hard and thin non-living is composed glucose. Its function protect the living parts of the cell. Now, protoplasm. Semi-solid, jelly-like, strictly and granular living substance. It contains cytoplasm and nucleus, which are the two main parts of the cell. Cytoplasm. Cytoplasm discovered was in 1831 by Robert Brown. Jelly-like substance outside the nucleus is named as cytoplasm. In cytoplasm, normally the following organelles are found. Number one, plastid. Number two, mitochondria, Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosome, lysosome, centriole, and cell vacuole, etc. are present. Now we discuss introduction of cell organelles. A small living structure covered with definite membranes present in cytoplasm are the cell organelles. Now, short discussions of this structure are given below. Plastid. Plastid were discovered and named by Arnett Haeckel. Round or elliptical organelles with or without pigment present in living cell are the name plastid. Normally, animal cells don't have plastid. Many plastids are two types, chromoplastids or colored, and leucoplastids or colorless plastids. Chromoplastids are two types, chromoplast and chloroplast. Boys, now I am going to describe function of plastid. Synthesis of food, pigmentation and storage of food, and the main function is to be held photosynthetic process for plants. Carrots. Now we discuss mitochondria. A small rod-like organelles dispersed in cytoplasm of plant and animal cells at the mitochondria. In mitochondria, there are two layers of membrane are present. Outer layer is smooth and the inner layer is folded inward like a finger. These are called tissue. Mitochondria is the source of energy used in metabolic activities in an organism. So it is called powerhouse of the cell. Then Golgi body. Camillo Golgi, 1898, are discovered. These are round or cell like organelles. Its function is to secrete enzymes and hormones, etc. Then centriole. Near the nucleus of an animal cell, there are two tube like organelles called centriole. Carrots. The main function of centriole is to form ester during cell division in animal cells. Carrots. Next, I am going to describe nucleus. A Scottish botanist, Robert Brown, 1831, is discovered. Fundamental unit of life, the nucleus is a small round and membrane bound structure found in cell. The fluid inside the nucleus stored by nuclear membrane is called nucleoplasm. It controls the cell's growth and reproduction because it contains cell's heredity information. That is, we know the nucleus consists of the following main parts. Number one, nuclear membrane. Number two, nucleoplasm. Number three, chromatin and nucleolus. Cadets, see the simple question. We follow this type of question for your exam. So try to solve it. Next, homework. Correct. You can see a diagram in slide. Now, follow the following figure and answer the following question. Our next class, different types of plants and animal tissue. Boys. Now, at the time of corona pandemic, we should follow the following habits. Eat a balanced and varied diet. Establish a routine and practice mindful eating. Keep hydrated. Practice self-food hygiene. Stay active at home. Get enough quality sleep. Get information from trusty source. Okay, boys. Thank you. See you next class.